I'm sorry, I must. It's just too hot out here. I need somewhere for the sweat to go. Last week on Patreon, I made this, which is a little mechanism to store my power tools in the Dream Mobile Woodshop on the wall and kind of have it a modular system, sort of a French cleat on steroids. I learned a lot from this prototype. It didn't work amazing, it worked okay. First thing I learned is you have to put your handles much lower, closer to the base of the tool. Initially, I had my hands kind of up here, and this just made it impossible to hold anything more than about 15, 20 pounds. Second, I learned that this safety latch on the bottom is not necessary, so I only need one release up at the top. I'm kind of just roughing out how this might work. I'll remake this if this is successful. And then somehow I've got to get this flat rod, or flat stock through the middle of this middle one. So kind of come up through, connect there. As you pull here, pulls here. I've got a different idea to manually route out the shape of the clip and then sandwich between the two boards, just following the lines by hand. While the epoxy sets up, I'm trying to decide if I would rather have a squeeze trigger or a push thumb trigger to release this. If I wanted to make a push button, I could attach it here and put a pivot point there so that when I push here, this pivots up kind of like this. But I'm just trying to decide what's better when you're lifting something heavy. Do you want to have your thumbs have to do the release or your pointers? I think you want your pointers. I've decided the most natural way for this to work is when it's retracted, it will be flush with the inside of the handle. There's going to be some sort of linkage between here and here.
Oh, that's so much better. Yeah. All right, I get this all worked out in SketchUp and then transferred it into Illustrator to lay out. And this is what I ended up with. The red areas are what I cut, blue areas are what I route, and the yellow is the thinner wood.
Success. Okay, now I've got two identical handles, but I did not think about how I was gonna attach these to the shelf itself. So that's the next step. And then we'll see if these are even worth making. Okay, I've got it mounted up on the wall outside the shop. Got a bench grinder on there. Pretty good. Definitely solid.
As someone who's never used this, go lift it off and give me your thoughts.
Go lift the whole thing?
Yeah, pretend to move it down, like down the trailer a little bit, move it to the back of the trailer. Pretty good.
It's pretty good.
Let's take this ridiculous thing off.
Feeling good about it. Tomorrow I need to come up with a better way to attach it to the platform, and then I also want to try it on something a little wider, maybe like 20 or 30 inches wide, and see if it's still manageable.
I spent the afternoon yesterday modifying these handles a bit so that this inside portion is connected all the way down the back, and it even comes out a little bit here, so it's kind of an L shape, and it holds my weight, so I'm definitely happy with this.
Here's the finished large size. This is as big as I would ever make it. And I put the scroll saw on it sideways, not because I would actually use it like this, just because I wanted something awkward and longer and off center on the weight. So the motor's back here in the corner. This would kind of represent like a strip sander or a disc sander. And still pretty manageable. Come on over, top, the bottom, and there it is.
You went the wrong way. It's gonna go that way.
All right, so say I'm doing a lot of metal work, and I want the grinder near the bandsaw or something. So I could come up, take this tool off, move it down to imaginary track somewhere else. Grab my grinder, again, off the imaginary track, come over. It's time to pull the car in the trailer. Smaller tools go up high. Bigger tools move forward. This over. That's it. I think it's a winner. Yeah.
Sweet.
as far as proof of concept goes, I think I'm going to move forward with it. I'm happy with it.
Alrighty, that's a wrap, huh?
That's a wrap. Thanks for watching. Bye. See you next week.
There's something definitely going on in there.
This week on Patreon, I take apart a broken drill to see if I can figure out why it broke and if I can fix it. $1 a month gets you access to that. Patreon.com/Mike and Lauren.